as we continue covering politics this afternoon, Vice President Kamala Harris now has enough committed delegates to claim the Democratic nomination in the wake of Joe Biden's withdrawal. And as News 15's Connor Hansen shows us, she's making her first campaign stop in a key swing state.
The path to the White House goes through Wisconsin.
Vice President Kamala Harris spoke to supporters in Wisconsin just days after Republicans held their convention in the key battleground state.
I pledge to you, I will spend the coming weeks continuing to unite our party so that we are ready to win in November.
The vice president has already raised more than $100 million for her campaign since President Biden said he's stepping aside Sunday. She's also secured enough delegates to be the party's nominee and is raking in key endorsements. Democratic leaders Hakeem Jeffries and Chuck Schumer now saying they support Harris at the top of the ticket.
She said she would work to earn the support of our party, and boy, has she done so in quick order.
Soon, Harris will have to choose a running mate, a process that typically takes months. Among those on her reported shortlist are Arizona Senator Mark Kelly and Pennsylvania Governor Josh Shapiro, both from key battleground states.
The vice president has a deeply personal decision to make as to who she wants to run with, who she wants to govern with, and who she thinks is prepared to help her lead the nation.
The Democratic National Committee will meet this week to decide how to move forward, but it will likely choose its candidate in a virtual delegate meeting in early August before the convention. In New York, Connor Hansen, News 15.